A place to be, to groom your words. A place that is secure for the rest of mine. No other place but Burial Schools. Burial Schools is the best.
Hello, lovely children. How are you today? You are welcome once more to our this platform on our e-learning. I'm Mrs. S.C. Edema. Okay, today I'll be taking you on basic science, and the topic is movement in animals. Movement in animals. Okay, now, hope you can walk. I'm sure everybody can walk. Beautiful. What do you use to walk? You use your legs. You walk with your legs. Is it not? Your feet. You walk with your feet. Okay, you walk with your feet. You walk with your feet. Beautiful. Now, different animals have their different ways they walk. They have their different ways of movement. They have their different ways of movement. They have different ways they move. We are going to look at them one by one. Take this note down. Now, we want to define movement. And it's on the board. Movement means a way by which living things move from one place to another. Movement means a way by which living things move from one place to another. Movement, it means a way by which living things move from one place to another. Now, let's say it together. Movement means a way by which living things move from one place to another. Let's say it again one more time. Movement means a way by which living things move from one place to another. That is beautiful. Now, we are going to look at ways animals move. There are different ways animals move. Just like I told you, animals move in different ways. Number one, by crawling. How many of you have seen the snake before? Beautiful. A snake crawl. Snail crawl. And earthworm crawl. There are so many animals that crawl, but we have the snake, example of animal that crawl. We have the snake, the earthworm, and the snail. The snake, the earthworm, and the snail. There are so many others. Now, number two, another way which animal move is by flying. By what? Flying. By what? Flying. And you should know your birds. Your birds, they fly. All right. Another way is by hopping. Number three, by hopping. And you know your frogs, up, grasshopper, and your kangaroo. All these are examples of animals that hop. Your frog, your grasshopper, and your kangaroo. There are so many of them. There are so many animals that hop apart from these ones. Okay. Another one is by walking. By walking. By walking. Number one, I say by crawling. Number two, by flying. Number three, by hopping. Number four, by walking. Example of animals that move by walking is human beings, you and I. You and I, we move by walking. Another one is galloping. By galloping. That is another way which animals move, by galloping. Examples is your horses, your cats, your dogs, the sheep, your cow, your goat, and so many other animals that move by hopping. Number six, I say by swimming. Swimming. That is another way which animal move. Swimming. Example are your, they are your fishes or aquatic animals. You know what aquatic animals are. Aquatic animals are animals that live in water. All right, now we are going to look at why animals move. Why do they move from one place to another? Why do they move? Why is it that animals are not like trees, they're in one place? We are going to see that now. Why animals move? We are going to look at reasons why animals move. And I said number one, in search of food. In search of food. They move to search for food. If they stay in one place, they will not have food to eat. They move in search of food. Number two, to find a new home. Number three, for reproduction. They move from one place to another so that they will see their kind to reproduce with. And number four,
to change their environment. To change their environment. Okay, I said our topic in basic science is movement in animals. Movement in animals. And we define movement as movement means a way by which living things move from one place to another. A way by which living things move from one place to another is called movement. And we also mentioned some ways animals move. Some ways animals move. Number one, we said by crawling. For example, your snake, your snail, your earthworm, and so on and so forth, they crawl. Number two, by flying. We mentioned birds. Examples of animals that fly, they are birds. Number three, by hopping. Number three, by hopping. Examples of animals that hop. Your frog. Hope you've seen the frog before. The frog hops. Your grasshopper, your kangaroo, etc. Number four, by walking. Number four, by walking. Example of animals that walk. We human beings, we walk. Okay. Number five, by galloping. Number five, by galloping. Examples of animals that gallop are the horses, cats, dogs, sheep, cows, goats. There are so many of them. And number six, swimming. For example, your fishes in the river, they swim. All aquatic animals, those animals in the water, that they are called aquatic animals, they swim. Okay, and I say, why animals move? Why do they move from one place to another? Number one, in search of food. Food is very important, not only to you and I, but also to other animals. Number two, to find a new home. Number two, to find a new home. Number three, for reproduction. And number four, to change their environment. All right, hope you enjoyed the lesson for today. Now it's time for your home activity. Here is your home activity on the board. Number one says, define movement. We say movement means a way by which living things move from one place to another. Movement means a way by which living things move from one place to another. Number two, state any three ways by which animals move. We say by crawling, by flying, by hopping, by walking, by galloping, by swimming. You tell me any three of them. Then number three, list three reasons why animals move. List three reasons why animals move. Number one, I said in search of food. Number two, to find a new home. Number three, for reproduction. Number four, to change their environment. Tell me any three reasons why animals move. Wow.
It has been an interesting lesson. Hope to see you next time. Bye.